Way shrines of the Nine in the wilderness confer blessings.
I'd advise you to keep your distance from that accursed. Count Indoris has ordered us to hold our positions until fair winds from inside that accursed Oblivion Gate. I hope Otessa is taking care of herself. Gifted healer, she spends all time helping others. Haven't you heard about the gates to Oblivion opening up all over Tamriel? Well, you know what they're capable of producing, although nothing is ever since Farwell entered. About 2 years ago, Count Indaris' son, Farwell, entered the Oblivion Gate with 6 other men. We haven't heard from them since then. The Count is the worst, and is posted here so we can watch and see if anyone comes back out. Far, nothing. At this point, Count Indaris is offering a reward for the rescue of his son from inside the gate. Confirmed news of his demise. If you find him, or the rest of the Knights of Dragonborn, get them out of. I'm sure the Count would also be pleased if the gate closed. New to these parts, eh? The Knights of the Thorn are a bunch of rabble who fancy themselves true knights. Arwill formed the group around. They make grand boasts and talk a good talk, but that's all they are. The real work goes to us, the Sigurd. I hate to speak ill of them, as something horrible may have happened, but their own bravado got them into this mess. It's tolerated because Farwell is the Count's son, plain and simple. He has the power and the coin to put it all together. Most of the time, he comes around the tavern drinking and making up stories of epic battles with impossible odds that they won. It's all garbage. They never patrol. They never help fight off the occasional that slips into the city. Well, I've said too much already. There are 7 of them, including Farwell. Even though they're a nuisance, I still hope they haven't been hurt. Or worse. Farwell is a Dunmer. He's wearing steel-plate armor. His shield should be the crest of the knights. Nothing but the best for the Count's son. There's only one way to remove that gate. Venture inside. The gate sigil stone. Take it. Once you have it, the gate should be closed. From what I hear, you'll appear back where you entered, safe and sound. We will remain until the gate is either closed or something emerges inside. We need to warn of impending attacks. Tread carefully.
Please, although I'm concerned about the safe return of my son and the closing of the gate, please see Aminus Gregory for all of the details. With a possible attack looming, I must be free to make preparations. Good luck!
Thank you.
Ha! Help at last.
It's about time someone got here. What took you so long? We are knights sworn to uphold the laws of Chadenhall. We fear no being, and we strike fast and true as lightning. Many wish to join our ranks, as we are of the highest echelon.
Only a select few may join the finest force ever to grace the lands of Cyrodiil. Until now, we numbered only 7, but attacked like a regiment. Our enemies quake at our approach and falter at our charge. Huzzah!
I set out with the rest of the knights to dispatch this blemish on the face of our fine world. When we arrived, we were overwhelmed. I myself was able to kill perhaps 20 of them, but they just kept coming. Only Brennan and I remain alive. However, with you here now, we can take the sigil stone from that citadel and complete our quest for the good of all Chaidenhall. Are you mad? A Knight of the Thorn never returns home until the mission is done. It's our way. Now, in my father's name as Count Indoris of Chaidenhall, I order you to lead me to that sigil stone. I suggest we use the Raymond sweep formation. You'll assault, and we'll guard the rear flank. Onward and upward! Huzzah! The sigil stone for this Oblivion Gate is the key. As soon as we have it, we shall rid Chaidenhall of its existence. The path is yours. Lead on.
Even if Farwell doesn't say it, we appreciate that you're here. Don't judge Farwell too harshly. Most of what he says is fabricated, but he's young and therefore quite brash and inexperienced. All he wants to do is please his father. I've known him since he was a lad, and fighting to defend Chaidenhall is in his heart. I just wish his heart was bigger than his hubris. I'm sure you wish to hear the real story, rather than Farwell's version. Not long after the gate opened, Farwell decided an assault was in order. We charged inside and promptly met resistance. 3 of us were cut down in the first wave. We pressed on at Farwell's behest. At the base of the citadel, we met a larger second wave of foes. We lost 2 more in that skirmish, as well as Farwell and I being wounded badly. It was at this point we considered retreat. We found the way back blocked by more Daedra. So we were stuck here until rescued by you. It's just like Farwell to leap before he looks. Had we brought a City Watch contingent, we might have taken the Sigil Stone with minimal losses. Instead, Farwell wanted to prove his point. The City Watch and the Knights of the Thorn are always at odds. They think we don't have what it takes, and Farwell wanted to show them. Perhaps we're all to blame, but that's not important right now. We must complete our journey and get that stone. Please, help us. Let's keep moving.
What's the matter? Getting tired? Let's get this over with! Am I supposed to be impressed? You're...
Hello there.
The council runs the arena to amuse the masses. And it pays for itself. Thank you.